We're Capstone Corporation. My name is Ryan Eidsmoe.
I'm Scott Shelton.
I'm Celina Vargas.
And I'm Michael Christiansen. And today we're here to talk to you about
workplace ergonomics.
Ergonomics covers topics such as overexertion,
eye strain from staring at a computer screen,
and stress from overworking.
The risk that you may face on the job. It's been proven that ergonomics can reduce the risk of these injuries. These injuries are called work-related musculoskeletal disorders, or WMSDs.
The different types of WMSDs are tendonitis, bursitis, low back disorders, and carpal tunnel syndrome.
Areas of injuries include
shoulders, abdomen, hips, ankles, lower back, and upper back.
These injuries can be severe, but if they're caught and addressed early on before symptoms occur, these will not develop into severe disorders.
Here at Capstone Corporation, we believe in the benefits of a successful ergonomics program.
While ergonomics are typically used to create a safer, more healthful work environment, your company may experience other benefits as well. These benefits may include
increased productivity, increased work quality, reduced turnover, reduced absenteeism, and increased morale.
Improving ergonomic conditions begins with developing an ergonomic plan, then communicating that plan with your employees. And then getting employee feedback to improve the ergonomic plan as a whole.
Now I'm going to be talking to you about sources of injury in the workplace. Before I talk to you about the actual sources, I'd like to talk to you about some of the bodily tissues that injuries can happen to, as well as some of the symptoms that those injuries are happening. Now what we have here, injuries to muscles, tendons, ligaments, nerves, and blood cells. Now WMSDs can be affecting any of these parts of your body. Some symptoms that a WMSD may be affecting you is discomfort, pain, fatigue, swelling, stiffness, and numbness and tingling. Now, as we pan over here, some of the sources of these injuries: strains, overexertion, striking, being struck by, as well as repetitive motion. Now, as you can see here, I've drawn up a little example listing some of the different types of injuries that can be attributed to all of these things that we've been discussing. We have tennis elbow, neck strain, shoulder tendonitis, lower back pain, and carpal tunnel. And with good ergonomics plans, we can make sure that these injuries do not happen. As mentioned earlier, ergonomics are designed to reduce WMSDs, or work-related musculoskeletal disorders. Now what I'm going to be talking about here in my diagram are the most common areas of injury, and how much each one of those areas of injury can cost an individual in the workplace. Now, if you can guess which one of these areas are, good for you, but let me fill in the blanks for you, make it a little easier. Now that we've drawn in the diagram and filled in the numbers, the top five most common areas of injury in the workplace, the neck, shoulders, elbow, wrist, and back. Neck come in at $19,149, shoulders come in at $15,085, elbow at $9,969, wrists at $11,950, and back at $10,094. Now if you just do this in your head, simple math, it comes out to be about $66,247. Now tell me, do you want to be paying this?
Workers' claim costs for injuries in the workplace consist of three main categories. General office work consisting of 35% of the injuries, materials and handling at 32%, and computer-related work coming in at 33%.
Now we want to address some of the risk factors and activities associated with these disorders.
Some of the risk factors include repetition, static loading, postures, lifting, carrying, and storage. Other factors include extreme temperatures and vibration.
Repetition. Performing the same or similar task for a long period of time can result in damage to joints and also surrounding tissues. This could be anything from an assembly line to working on a keyboard or any other activity for a long period of time.
Static loading. This is caused by sitting for long periods of time. This will reduce circulation and cause muscle tension.
Symptoms of eye strain are dry, itchy eyes, tired eyes, sore eyes, headaches, and blurred or double vision. And eye strain has been known to cause headaches, sore neck, and fatigue. For proper monitor height and distance to prevent eye strain, consider positioning your monitor at least 18 inches from your eyes, but not too far to where your eyes have to strain to read the screen. Align the top of the screen to be 10 to 20 degrees below your horizontal line of sight, and tilt up 10 to 20 degrees so the screen remains perpendicular to your line of sight. If wearing bi- or trifocals, the screen may need further adjustment to provide for clear sight through glasses.
Posture is a key element to preventing future WMSDs. By straightening your back, pulling back your shoulder blades, and having your shoulders pulled back and relaxed, sticking at your chest and strengthening your core, you can take pressure off of your back in general and in the future not have problems with your lower back.
For proper posture while sitting at a computer, make sure your head is level or bent slightly forward. Your elbows stay close into the body. Your feet are fully supported by the floor. Your back is fully supported with appropriate lumbar support while sitting vertical or leaning back slightly. Your thighs and hips are supported by a well-padded seat, and your knees are about the same height as the hips.
Tips to consider when lifting, carrying, and storing materials. First, keep the load close to your body. Second, avoid lifting objects from the floor. 3, plan ahead. And 4, get help when needed.
Consider the placement of materials on the work shelves. Consider the weight of the materials on the shelves and where you might like to place the materials. The required motions of the body required to access the materials, whether that's bending or reaching. store heavy and frequently used items just below waist height, approximately 29 inches. Store lighter but frequently used items between the knee and the shoulder height. Store lighter, less frequently used items above shoulder height. And use a sturdy tool to store items higher on shelves as opposed to reaching to reduce injuries to the shoulders.
In all, ergonomics will create an environment in your workplace free of hazard, free of stress, and free of lost time and injury. Workers feel good about coming to work due to increased safety, and their productivity will go through the roof, even higher than they could have thought imaginable. And I can guarantee, ergonomics will affect you in the workplace.
Welcome to Capstone Stretch and Flex. Let's start by inhaling and exhaling. Bend your head to the right and slightly pull. Now to the left and pull. Pushing back and pull. Back and pull. Now shoulders forward, rotation. Now back. Now send your right arm up and just pull up. Switch to the left and pull up. Now the wrist. Your hands forward, gentle fist, bend down and rotate to the outside. Now in. Fingers up and pull back. Other hand, pull back. Spread your legs and just gentle rotate your back. Grab your hip bones and stretch back. One, two. Now the calf muscle, point your toes up and push down. Up and down. Up and down. Next foot. Up. Down. That is it. Thank you for watching.